Here, in doing ahead, in the days of illustration, and if I had a situation where the head had to be turned away, I'd sit in front of a mirror and just do what I could see. And then I would erase all the, and I'd say, I think, how much of his nose would I see if his head is turned away? Well, I just do that. And then I run down the cheek line. I bring that ear forward. See, and that's how much nose would be seen. But these were tricks that we used because they would pay $7 for a single page and 15 or so for the double page, and you had to turn out a lot of them to make a living. And you couldn't take the time to have models or anything like that. So you had to improvise ways of working without them. And you had to be very fast. And you worked in black and white, and if you had a good feeling, actually, I still have a holdover of that. Like, I like to prepare a drawing in black and white, and then the things that are dark will be dark in value in the color. The things that are light will be light in value. So even though I did it in pencil, I know that if that were in paint, it would have to be dark. It would be a dark value on my painting. The parts that I kept light will be light.
And there, people.
But I could do that all in pencil. I could decide right then. For instance, if I know the light is coming from here on the horse, then this part would all be
in
shadow. There'd be the shadow would be underneath there, and this part would be in the light, right here. And your highlight would be where you, in understanding the drawing, you'll understand this is the part of the rump where it turns over. You know that.
The muscle.
Well, and you know the light, the strongest light would be on that. I was giving a class in New Mexico, and we had a gray horse standing underneath the tree, and the light was filtering down through the tree. Mm-hmm. And you know that when it splashes on that horse, you know, the class was working on it, I worked on it, I couldn't get it. It wasn't satisfying to me. What was I doing wrong? So I was walking around, and one of the students got it. And I try to study, you know, it's a two-way thing, mm-hmm. learning. You know, I might know a hell of a lot about a lot of things, and a hell of a lot of things I don't know about. And I start trying to figure out what was it that made that. Now, whenever I did it on this gray horse, it looked as though I had spotted the horse. Mm-hmm. And yet it wasn't spotting the horse, it was sunlight hitting it. Now, how do you get that? And I realized that I was too strong, that even though looking at it in reality, it looked like it was a stark white hitting. But in reality, when you really get close, it's not a sharp white. It's kind of a softer white. And when I started going down and making a softer light hitting that horse, even though when I looked at it from a distance, it looked as though there were spots of real sunlight on it, then it started coming off. And then when I came home, I did a painting which is now going somewhere. I call it First Meeting. And it's two foals meeting for the first time. And one of the mothers of one is underneath this tree, and she's gray, and the sunlight is coming out, spotting her. And that's why I wanted to do it. And I fussed with that, and it finally came off. It was was so satisfying, I thought I'd made a couple of million bucks in one shot. And, but anyway, I found out how to make that light. But you're finding out things all the time. Yes?
Sam, I know that some people will start out